I'm the small forward, and I can never bring it up. It's called being a basketball slave. Nobody wants to be a basketball slave. You gotta wait for the point guard to do all the work. I want to have fun too. You think Big Ty wants to have fun? We don't know what Ty can do. Maybe Ty can shoot threes. We don't know. So when I'm coaching, I always tell my guards, I give my bigs 2 turnovers a game. They get the rebound, they can do anything they want. And if they turn it over twice, I call timeout, and I put them to the bench, and I say, okay, next game. You know? And then I say, when we get to practice, we're going to get better. We're going to work on our dribbling, we're going to get better. So, I believe, when you look at the athletes in the Philippines, and how much time do I have? But I want to talk about defense too. I have about 25. Okay. So when you look at the athletes in the Philippines, there's a lot of athletes out here. Okay. And as you know, boxing, Pacquiao, even yesterday, both guards was speed, defense. So you have to utilize that to your advantage and develop your anybody 6'7" or lower, you gotta develop them on here. And they will be able to compete. Because if you look at the Warriors, Draymond Green, he's 6'7". And Draymond Green was going up against 7 points. Draymond Green had 35 points against 7 against the Cavaliers when they lost to the Cavs to LeBron James. So, I wanted to think about that. So now, one of the things I like to do, we'll talk about training camp. When I'm coaching my teams, and my teams are in training camp, I usually don't like to touch the basketball for like the first 5 days. I like defense. And I mean, you want your players to learn, and you don't want to kill your players where they got injured, pulling a hamstring, you know, overworking them. I don't want to do that. But I want to teach defense. So what I used to do, when I got Defensive Player of the Year, before I touched the ball, the first 45 minutes was all defense. So, zig zag drill. Slide. Slide in here. That's one. Slide in there. Two. Here. All the way back. All the way down here. Back. That's one. I would do that 5 times. Then, what I would do is I would do my agilities. Define a line, you can go 1 foot. I'll do that like 35 times. Other foot. You do it twice. Forward. You gotta train your feet to be quick. So, me being, I was 6'7", 250, and I had to guard bigs and I had to guard point guards. Sometimes I had to guard Allen Iverson. So, you want to train the body. You can't just go onto the floor and play and be a great defender. It don't work like that. You gotta work on it the same way you work on your shot. I have another drill that I do. If somebody wants to try it, anybody wants to try a defensive drill, it's pretty cool. I like it. I call it Hawaii Land. Anybody wants to try it?
Try.
Come on.
Go.
Whoever wants to try it, come out. I'll take 10 people max. 12,000 over there. Alright. So, I'm gonna take you through some defense. Alright, I don't want y'all to hurt yourself. So, can you jog up and back like four times? Just to get loose.
Imba lang gusto niya.
Nice. The next one is really hard. Hey, back. Good job. One more. Keep your butt down. Nice. Where is he going? You see, when you get tired as a basketball player, you can't think. So you want to train the kids so when they get tired, they can think. This is also good for offense. Good job, everyone. It's good for offense. Come on, come up. Okay. I just want to feel that. This drill is built for offense. You want to be down. For offense, you don't want to be up. You want to be down. Okay. You want some water? Okay. If you need water, you know what? I'll give you that 1 minute. But so, like I said, I was doing that every day because I knew I wasn't as good as Kobe. I wasn't as good as T-Mac. I couldn't score as much. And if I can't score, I'm not going to win. So now you see that the score is 120 to 150. When we played the Celtics, it was 83-79. Sometimes you win the game on defense. You can win the game on defense. Okay, everybody face this way. This is called Kawhi Leonard, because I love Kawhi Leonard. I seen Kawhi Leonard one day. I'm giving you a reason why I started this drill. And my sons hate me for this drill. Kawhi Leonard, he was guarding Kevin Durant. And Kevin Durant hit him with that long crossover. And Kawhi Leonard said, and he went all the way back. Kawhi Leonard went like this, and Kawhi Leonard went like that, on balance. And I'm a defender, and I was like, wow! You know, I was so excited. You know, most times people get excited for 3-point shots, and then dunks. I'm like, wow. Because Kawhi Leonard could have went like this. And Kevin Durant did it with my body. Kawhi Leonard had fundamentals, and Kawhi Leonard, he was ready. Anything Kevin Durant did, Kawhi was ready. So when I seen that, I'm like, I got to turn that into a girl. So face that way. Face that way. Watch me. We're gonna keep our butt down, okay? And get a little bit tired. Up and back is one. And if you get tired, stop, because I don't want you to hurt yourself. Or you got water in there, you might need it. Don't get nervous, though. Okay, so what we're gonna do is keep our butt down, and we're gonna get our knees up. What's gonna happen? You don't want to bounce. You don't want to knees. Big knees to the ceiling. All right, knees to the ceiling. Butt down. Up and back is one. We're gonna try to four. Ready, set, go. Put your butt down. Butt down. When you play defense, you want to be able to stay here for 48 minutes. Come back. So you want to teach. butt down. Is there any way you want to lift weights? Chest muscles. Is there any way you do squats? This is not easy.
Ang hirap nun.
Yeah. Oh, you heard the dragon yesterday, right?
Yes.
So,
anyway,
so that's really tough. So usually, once I get here, I go right away. Four times. So, you can go if you want, but it's really hard. But it's the same thing like working on your shot. Just repetition. You don't want to go 4 times? No, right? Oh, that's hard. No, don't do it. Yeah. That's a hard kill. But it's really good for the brain. And you want to do that drill like once every like 4 days. I did it every day, but that's fun. I mean, if you want to push it, if you got a player who's hard, you got a lot of heart. But you got a lot of heart. You can do it like today, and tomorrow, but the next day, like, give them a rest. Let them recover. So, the reason I do that drill, and I'm going to do one more drill with y'all. The reason I do that drill is because the same way we got to get stronger, so we do push-ups. You do toe raises, you do squats, you do sit-ups, curls, shoulder. This is a defensive muscle. You can't come in a game and expect to be down here for 40 minutes. When you play for me, I need to be picking up all the time. And then if I see you tired, I'll say, pick him up at half court. When I see you that energy, you can come up at full court. So that's the defensive muscle that I get to see. Now, when you need that 4 times, not only is it good for defense, but like I said, it's good for offense. So, the next drill is for your foot quickness. So, we just get on the line like right here. And I want y'all to go just up and back. You can go 20. And then one leg, 20, all the leg, 20, to the side. 20, one leg, and the other leg. Let's see, you can just go through and see how it feels. If you get tired, just go back. Ready, go. And up. And back is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you can use this drill maybe once every 3 days. That'd be enough to keep your kids quick. You can rest here. I remember when I got the defensive player of the year. So when I got the first player of the year, Rick Carlisle. Y'all know Rick Carlisle, the coach? You guys know Rick Carlisle?
No.
From Dallas? Okay. So, with me and Bruce Long, and Anthony Wallace. So, we all trying to get the defensive player of the year. So Rick Carlisle did research, and Rick Carlisle said he presented to the NBA all the coaches, and I held all small forts to an average of 6 points for the entire season. So sometimes I would hold people to 0 points, all stars. So when I'm playing defense, I never want you to score, ever. Sometimes Kobe is hard. Sometimes Kobe is, you know, humiliating. But sometimes I get lucky. Sometimes I get lucky and score 20 of 15. But it didn't happen much. But there were other all stars, 2 points, 0 points, 3 points, right? And in the summertime, I'm working on my defense. So if you're working on your offensive game in the summertime, and all you're doing straight up and down, working like this, working like that, and if you're not working like this as an offensive player, if you're not doing all your drills low, that means on defense, you can't beat me. I'm here for 48 minutes. You cannot get by me. And then when you try to get low, and when you try to get low, you're tired. You're tired to continue. Right? So that's why I work on my defense. I work on my defense every day. Let's talk about transition defense. So one of the drills I like, all right, you get five offensive plays and five defensive plays. Okay, who wanna play? Okay, offense. Who wanna do this? Okay, good. Okay. Okay, so you're okay, whoever wants to take his shirt off, you're on defense. You're on offense. So who wants to take his shirt off?
Defense. Defense. Offense.
I need all the defense to take his shirt off.
Ball.
Right. So, and all your teaching here. Active hands. Okay?
Like this. Right. Good. All right.
So that's some tips on defense when you're telling your players. Never follow your opponent on the other side. We want to protect the paint. Protect the paint. Okay. Let's talk about transition. Okay, flip it. Offense, defense. Okay. So take it out. Guard him. Okay. You can go here. Okay. Elbow. Defense. Okay. So let's assume we're seeing the ball. So can you go one step? Okay, cool. So let's assume this is a fast break, right? And we're trying to get a stop. So, now everybody come up. Hold on. Can you go to the corner? Okay. So you know on a fast break, it's always off balance. So anytime it's a fast break and everybody's running, the last person down, always run opposite. Because yesterday you saw the game, there was a lot of fast breaks. Got him. Everybody move up. And you say last, move up. Move up. And everybody come up. And an offense and the defense stay there. Offense room. Okay, cool. All right. So we all on offense on a fast break. So I didn't know what to score, grab the basketball, and then trap the basketball, throw the basketball. So on a fast break, this is always open. So everybody, find a man, and you're running opposite, okay? And also, the same way we did that last drill, first drill, it's called shell defense. You want to be able to teach the kids shell defense while they're running, right? So if I'm running back with defense, got it. Got the basketball. You want to be able to do that in transition. You want to be able to run, turn, and be able to help in transition. Some people can only do half court, shell defense. So I don't have a lot of time today. But you want to practice transition defense, right? So if you stop your opponent's transition, you can get out. You can get out and run. And you can bring it in today. And so usually, so he asks, or the last hand, go back. He's wide open, right? So you want to run. You don't want to run center because the ball's there, right? Yeah. You want to run right there. Yeah, that's good. You want to work on I do one last drill. Okay, sit right here. So, one of the hardest things to guard, So, if this is Kevin Durant, one of the hardest things to guard is passing the ball. Kevin Durant from the ass, it's really hard to guard. Not everybody's Kevin Durant. So, if you want to teach your players, pass it. Once you get halfway, give it up. Chop off your feet. And you don't always want to be in a place of doing defense with fundamentals. Some players do that jump. Some players go. They have no control. You want to go, you want to run. And then once you get about right here, tell them to break your feet down, tap your feet. Some players go, you know that? Step carry. They let them shoot because they're intimidated. You want your players to pass the ball halfway and break it down. You can call it like the whole island, it's really good at that. Another drill. I'm gonna give y'all one more drill that you can do with your team. You do it with one person in your house, so go here. You go out. Go here. That's it at all. In an office. In an office. Okay. Go corner. Go wing. D corner. You got that way? Yeah, so I'm going to finish up here. I'm going to open it up to my 85 questions. But these are all drills. And some of the drills I'm learning from my coaches. And some of the drills I learned because I want to learn how to win. So you can make up your own drills. You don't really need anyone to help you make up the drills for you. But as long as you give an effort and you think that, you can come up with all sorts of drills to make your plan better. So, does anybody have any questions? Or is that good? All right, cool. No questions? Okay, good. Well, that's it, I think. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Ba't kinuha yun ba?
Dapat nga binigay na yun eh. Tatapon na yun.
Okay, so we're gonna give some stuff to the participants. So all the participants do that.
Kami yung mga ano?
Cebuano.
Taga-Cebu. Taga-Cebu. Metta World Peace.
Lakers fans.
Lakers fan.
India Lakers fans.
Yeah, we are Lakers fans.
There you go. Alright, we got something special for all of those that participated in Coach Metta World Peace drills. Alright. And they can have photo op with Coach Metta World Peace. Once again, big hand for Coach Metta World Peace. There you go. And that's how MBTC works for you. Coming up is Coach's Convention. Okay. And it's all brought to us by Go for Gold. We're still going to be... Yes, yes, come on, come on, come on, yo! There you go. That's courtesy of Go for Gold.
Alright,
one more.